Hi, this is Chuck of Hire Chuck, and welcome to the first of my video series around home technology. This is one of the areas in which Hire Chuck can bring value to you and your family. So the purpose of the first video in the series is to give you an introduction to home technology and help you to make a determination if it's worth it to you. So first of all, what is this thing called home technology, or also known as smart home technology? Well, it's a lot of the things that you might think of normally, like as smart lighting, video doorbells like Ring, smart door locks, smart thermostats, home assistants like the Amazon Alexa that's behind me, or Google's version, which is their home assistant. But it's a lot more. It can also include wireless speakers to help you bring sound to areas in your home that you couldn't get to before. Universal remotes, which have been around for a long time but have come so much further in their ability to simplify how you control your entertainment. Water main shutoffs and smart irrigation systems that allow you to protect your home as well as save money. So what smart technology isn't, it isn't stuff that you put in your home that's going to create a HAL from the movie 2001, you know, where the computer actually takes control and you become a slave to it. It's quite the opposite. It really is technology that puts you more in control of your home. And just so you know, SMART is actually an acronym. It stands for something, which is Self-Monitoring Analysis and Reporting Technology. So what this means is it's technology in your home, these Internet of Things that are connected to your home and allow them to monitor your home and report to you the status of the home, allowing you to take action. Okay, so a lot of people are saying, yeah, Chuck, that's all well and good, but I don't need this. And you know what? You're right. You don't need it. But I'm going to have you think about something. Back before 1980, a lot of people didn't think that they needed computers. As a matter of fact, back in 1977, the CEO of one of the world's largest computer companies, Digital Equipment Corporation, or DEC, Ken Olson, legendarily said at a conference he would never see the day when a computer was needed in the home. Well, you know, back in 1977, a lot of people probably would agree with that. But look at where we are now, you know, and look at, by the way, where DEC is now, you know. So the idea of living without something like this, you don't need it, but then once you have it, you can't live without it. I think that's the state of what all this home technology is going to bring to the table. And as a matter of fact, I also see that it is happening now because it's growing at a pretty rapid rate. What I think is going to be good is to kind of look at a couple of examples of where it can make your life easier, okay? And then you can start, you know, jumping into it. So the whole idea is, with smart technology, it doesn't have to be a big bang. You can start and do things the way you want it and then grow as you seem fit. So think of the following scenarios. How many times have you left your home and have scratched your head and wondered, oh my goodness, did I leave the garage door open? I don't know what to do at this point. Or, you know what? I have this gnawing feeling that my kids left the garage door open. Wouldn't it be nice to allow you to find out when you're remotely away if the door is open, or even be notified if it's been open for a long period of time, and then being able to close it remotely? Or how about the situation where you have kids and they forget the keys and can't get in the house? Wouldn't it be nice to be able to remotely let them in the door or open the garage door for them? But here's another one. Think about this. Universal remotes. How many of you have a remote situation like this, where you have multiple remotes to control all the vast technology that you've got to have to get the best home entertainment system in the world? You love this, but then your significant other or spouse, all they want is to be able to turn on the television, and they're intimidated by what it takes to do this. It takes a PhD to be able to control your TV. Wouldn't it be nice to have something like this, where you can control everything from one device and you push a button to get what you want on, no questions? Or even better, wouldn't it be nice to be able to do something like this from time to time?
Alexa, let's watch a movie.
In this situation, Alexa first shuts off the lights in the adjacent room, turns on some mood lighting there, dims the light in this room, then talks to the universal remote to set all the components necessary to watch a DVD. Another area you can think of. People don't think about the value of it, but say you have a summer home, or if you're going away for a long period of time, How many of you heard stories of like a pipe breaking in a house? And when you come home from a long stay away, that you come home to see your floor flooded with water and you know thousands and thousands of dollars worth of damage done. If it didn't happen to you, I'm sure probably you've heard of somebody you've had this happen to. Wouldn't it be nice if leak was detected that it would actually shut off the water? Another area I touched upon earlier is a smart irrigation system. You know, in my house, before I had this, we have a sprinkler system, and almost every day that it was watering the lawn, that if it was raining out or about to rain, I'd get a call from my wife Stephanie saying, "You realize the irrigation system's on?" Well, yeah, and you know, for the longest time, that is because the case that there's a shutoff, but it requires a little cork to get saturated with water and shut it off. Wouldn't it be nice that if you had a system that could kind of monitor if it was about to rain and not water if it was going to be raining? Or even better still, that based upon the historic, you know, how much water has happened from rain standpoint, say, you know what, the lawn doesn't need watering today, so I'm going to skip it. This technology can save oodles of money for you. So when I was kind of trying to look for why people adopt smart technology, I've done research on it online and found out that there's a lot of articles on what smart technology is and why it's being adopted. And, you know, right here is kind of a list of what I think to be the common things that I see coming across the board. So first of all, it makes tasks in the home more convenient and enjoyable. It can save money on utilities, you know, like, as I talked about earlier, which is also good for the environment and good to be green. It can increase home safety within the cases of alarm systems, you know, door locks, remote door locks, and fire detectors and such. Peace of mind, knowing what's going on in your home when you're not around. And give you more control of your home, both when you're in the house in different ways that you have been doing in the past, but also when you're not there. So there's a lot of reasons that home technology's being adopted. Just 5 years ago, only about 13% of the homes in America had deployed some kind of home technology, 13%. Now, it's more than 38%. And studies are showing that it's going to be adopted by more and more homes at a rate of 22% year over year in the foreseeable future. So this is going to be ramping up. So the idea is, you know, like home PCs or smartphones, it's going to happen. So the idea is it time for you to jump in? Is it time for you to look what you could do for your home? If so, give me a call. You know, maybe we can help. My goal was to keep these videos as terse as possible. I probably went longer than I would have wanted in this time, but there was a lot to cover in this one. But hopefully it piqued your interest. So keep an eye out in the future. I'm going to be talking about more and showing more videos that address various areas of home technology, such as smart remotes, smart locks and garage door openers, video doorbells and cameras, smart lighting, and more. So until next time, have a great day, and thanks for watching.